We've recently seen a lot of news and hype and enthusiasm about the release of native NFTs, aka the XLS20 amendment on the XRP ledger. And some people might think it's related to smart contracts and hooks. It is not. I understand where people are coming from, because NFTs on other networks are implemented through smart contracts. And on the XRPL, like many awesome features as the DEX or multi-signing, they are native to the XRP ledger. So XLS20 is a proposal or started as a draft proposal of bringing native NFT functionality to the XRP ledger. So it's not draft anymore. It is a full-blown amendment. And it's now being voted on by network participants. It doesn't need hooks. It's native functionality. It does play very nice with hooks, because maybe you want to add your own custom logic to NFTs as well. The NFT can be anything. It can be your access to a concert. It can be a collectible. It can be an attestation to proof of your identity. It can be anything. It's just a blank object on the ledger you own that represents something. And we have a social contract on what it represents, basically. Now, it makes a lot of sense to do what hooks can offer, pre-transaction execution logic and post-transaction commit logic with NFTs, for example. Maybe you have your own conditions why you don't or do want to receive an NFT. Maybe you have your own conditions or logic that has to be executed after you send or mint an NFT. Maybe for every NFT you sell, again, concert ticket example, or no, better example, properties, houses, land registry. Maybe after selling a property being represented as an NFT, you automatically want to transfer funds from the account to, for example, the notary for their services, to the realtor for their services, to the land registry for the registration fee to transfer the deed into your name. So all of those things you can now do programmatically, verifiably, on ledger with hooks. So they play nice together. Now, NFTs, smart NFTs on the XRPL today on mainnet are not a real thing. It's still on devnet, but on mainnet, people, validator operators, are voting on the amendment. And we already had the amendment lock in at over 80% of the votes a couple of weeks back, until a very smart developer found a feature that could be exploited. So it wasn't really a bug in the source code, in the amendment. It was a perfectly fine feature, but it could be abused by an attacker to lock up unrecoverable funds by someone minting an or selling an NFT, which is not something you want, because in this global ecosystem, it's not if this is going to be abused, it's when it's going to be abused. And you could say that someone didn't configure their own ledger account settings well if this were to be abused, because you could prevent it by one simple flag, by not enabling the flag when you minted the NFT, or when you wanted to sell the NFT. But we all know that people are not reading the docs. They are going to turn on the flag because they like the feature, and then at some point they are going to be a victim of someone just locking their funds for sports. So the flag had to be removed. So that resulted in an updated amendment, and the voting process started again from scratch. And we're closing in on a lock-in of the amendment again, but there's no telling when that's going to happen, because we don't know who's going to vote when on a decentralized network. And we also don't know if maybe something else comes up. I hope not. I think not. But who knows? That's what we thought 3 weeks ago. But if all goes as planned, I think we can see XLS20 NFTs natively on the XRPL in a couple of weeks.